For this lesson, you need to open the sample file First Quarter Sales and Profit 4 from your Sample Files folder. Notice that columns B, C, D, and E are too wide for their contents. This makes them look a little strange. For example, the text Jan in cell B3 is shown to the left of the column, while the number in cell B4 is shown to the right of the column. If the column was a more appropriate width, things would look a lot better. So let's resize column B so that it's a more appropriate width. To do this, you need to hover the mouse cursor over the column header and on top of the intersection between columns B and C. When you see the resize cursor shape, you can hold down the mouse button and drag to change the width of the column. Notice also that you can see the width of the column in pixels and points shown in a tip that pops up. I'll make this column about this wide. And why not resize the other columns while we're about it? Now, even though the column widths look a lot better now, they're not absolutely perfectly the right size for the widest value in each column. In order to make them exactly the right size, I need to use a slightly different technique to auto-size the columns. To do this, I'll hover in the column headers at the intersection between columns B and C until I see that resize cursor shape again, and then double-click. I can do the same then for column C, column D, and column E. And columns B, C, D, and E are now perfectly the correct width for their contents. But you might have thought that was a lot of clicking. And wouldn't it be nice to be able to resize every column in a worksheet so that every column was absolutely the right width with a single double click? Well, of course you can do this. Let's begin by changing those widths so that they're all a slightly different column width. And then we'll resize each column in one operation. I need to introduce a new button to do this, and that's the Select All button. The Select All button is in the top left corner of the worksheet. When I click the Select All button, you can see that every cell on the worksheet is selected. Remember, that's over a million rows. To resize every column in one operation, I hover the mouse cursor in the column header at the intersection of any two columns and then double click. And every column is then resized in one operation. But notice that AutoSize has been rather too clever. It's resized column A so that it's wide enough to contain the text in cell A1. And that's probably not what I would want. I'd probably want to make column A wide enough for the values in cells A4 to A9. And here's how I'd do that. I select cells A4 to A9, and then on the Home tab of the ribbon, in the Cells group, I click Format, and then Auto Fit Column Width. And when I click, the column is perfectly sized to the contents of the selected cells. Notice that the text in cell A1 is now spilling over to the right, into cells B1, C1, D1 and E1. This is what happens when there's text in a cell and the adjacent cells are empty. But if there was a value in cell B1, you'd see that the text in cell A1 would be truncated. Let's delete that value from B1 and you'll see that things are once again the way we want them to be. As well as resizing columns, you can also resize rows. I'm going to resize row 3 so that it's a lot taller than it is now. So I hover over the intersection of row 3 and 4 in the row header area and then click and drag to make the row a lot taller. This is the correct way to space worksheets out so that they look attractive. You should never space worksheets by inserting padding rows. You'll find out why that's a really bad idea in Session 4, Making Your Worksheets Look Professional. And you've now completed Lesson 2.9, Resize Rows and Columns.